open. We compile it and run it. I made a really small matrix to begin with, so we can just see that it's acting correctly. So as you see, our input matrix goes from 0 to 63, and the transposed version does the same thing down the columns instead of the rows. So we've written correct code, as we expected, and we're just going to store this routine for generating this transpose in the gold matrix, and we'll use that to compare so we don't have to keep printing out these matrices. For the rest of the lecture, I'll leave a smaller window so that we can see the results without actually printing out the matrices. Okay, so here's how you code transpose on a serial machine like a CPU, and here's how you call it. So let's do our first CUDA version. We'll copy this, paste it, make it a kernel, rename it. So now we've got a kernel that'll operate on the GPU. And to call it, we need to do a few things. We need to allocate space for the input and output matrix on the device. So we'll allocate those. And we need to copy the input matrix onto the device, call our kernel. So what you see here is I've taken that same kernel that we wrote, a serial kernel, I've called it on a single thread, running in a single block, passed in d in and d out, and then I copy my result. And we're done. See, that was quick. GPU programming is easy. I'm actually making an important point here. Okay, this code is going to run correctly, and it was really easy to write. And the problem, of course, is that it won't perform very well, right? It's using a single thread, which is a really small fraction of the horsepower of a GPU, especially a high-end GPU, which can run tens of thousands of threads concurrently. So let's go ahead and time this. Okay, so I've added some timer code. Okay, we're going to start the timer, measure it, and I also added, I'm using a helper function here called compare matrices, which just compares the output to the golden matrix that we calculated to make sure that we did the transpose correctly. Let's compile again, run again. Great. So yes, we performed the transpose successfully, and it took some very small fraction of a millisecond. But this was a really small problem. Let's make this problem bigger again, say a 1024 by 1024 matrix. So now we've got roughly a million elements to touch, and we're going to do this in a single thread. Okay, now this is taking almost half a second. That's a long time.